Well, turn on Wagiv, Augusta Falger of Galera, again, Kiolaris Nashunta. It's so great to see real people. Look at you, it's great, isn't it great to see them back? Yeah. You look well, like 18 months. You haven't aged a bit. Absolutely, it's been great. It's so nice to have you here, and it means an awful lot to me and an NSO to have you here for our this evening's concert. So you're welcome, but a particular very strong welcome to the members of the Ó Riada family who are around. I see some here. Yes, please, that's great. It's so great to have you here, and it's an honour for myself and the members of the National Symphony Orchestra to play your father's music, and probably in some cases your grandfather's music as well, I'm sure. It's great to be here and to have you here with us. That was the music to Saoirse, which, as you know, was, well, could we call it the sequel to Mise Éire? And of course, no evening or afternoon's concert of Seán Ó Riada's music would be complete without Mise Éire, and we will have, you will hear that music later on in the programme. But that was Saoirse, and featuring on the Eland Pipes, the fantastic Mick O'Brien, who's left the stage. You can show your appreciation for Mick O'Brien as well. We're going to move on with a piece which is the latest piece written in today's programme. It was written in 1966. And I always think of the 1960s as a time when Seán, having been to the UK quite a number of times and been to France in the 50s, he kind of embedded himself in his native Cork, in County Cork, and obviously Cuala is a very important part of his legacy. And the piece we're going to play for you now features music from that part of the country, his beloved Cork. This is Ceol na Laoi. Thank you. Of course, many of you will know part of Seán Ó Riada's rich legacy is Curatorial Chulainn, and his work with traditional musicians was revolutionary. Nothing had been seen like that at the time in 1950s and 1960s Ireland. So it was wrong to have this programme and not acknowledge the role traditional musicians played throughout Seán's life, but also in maintaining his legacy today. So we've got a bit of a treat for you. You heard the fantastic piping of Mick O'Brien earlier on. His daughter is now going to come out and play some tunes for you now. You'll hear a set of three tunes. She'll start with Antina Bio Cuidahain, and then she'll play, I can't remember what the second tune is. I was told this earlier on. The Rolling Wave, that's what it was. It was in there somewhere. and she's going to finish the set with Paddy Taylor's. Will you welcome, please, the fantastic Aoife ní Bhriain?
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That was, of course, Nomos 1. It's amazing, actually, all the music in today's programme was written in the space of 10 years, from 1956 to 1966. And that piece was written in 1957. And the older I get, the more I appreciate how quickly Seán Ó Riada changed from one style to another. He travelled to the UK many times, but travelled to France in particular, and brought back a lot of that Central European avant-garde compositional style, atonal style, and experimented with it in a wonderful way, which you can hear in that piece there. We're rapidly coming to the end of our programme. That was kind of convincing. It's just been great to play for you people after 18 months of just looking at cameras. And at the end of our live stream, I get the National Symphony Orchestra to stand and we all pretend you're out there and smile out to the cameras, and we know you are out there. So thank you for being here. It's a great pleasure to have you back. Hooray! In a few minutes to end our programme, we play the music that needs no introduction, Mise Éire, and I know you're all going to love that. But before that, this is The Banks of Sullane. We hope you enjoy it, and thank you again for being here.
Thank you.